So we all know YouTube has all these numbers for us to access inside our analytics, right? If you're like me, you're not really a numbers person, so digging into all those numbers can be a little confusing and not really sure what to do with them. In fact, when I was going through my MBA, I tried to avoid as much accounting and finance classes as possible and tried to stick to the marketing because, like I said, numbers just weren't my thing. But avoiding your analytics could really hurt your channel, and it could also blow up your channel in a good way. So then I'm gonna leave the rest of this laundry here, and let's go into my office so I can share with you an easy way to read your YouTube analytics like a pro. Even if you're a very beginner at looking at any of these numbers, this is honestly going to make the biggest difference to your channel. Let's go. Okay, so when you're creating YouTube videos, you really wanna make sure you're working smarter, not harder. Look, if you're anything like me, I am limited to the amount of time that I can really spend on creating content when I have 2 kids under the age of 5. So I wanna make sure when I do post a YouTube video, it's actually going to move my channel forward. It's actually gonna get views, it's going to cause more subscribers to come to my channel, right? So let me just pull up my analytics and let's go through step by step what you should be looking at and 3 of the most important analytics. If you're super low on time, you've only got 10 minutes a month to look at this, let me show you the 3 that you should definitely always check. So hit that like button if you're excited to learn about numbers, even if you are not a numbers person like me. When you first get into YouTube Studio, you're gonna see your dashboard. Now this dashboard is really important because you're gonna see your latest video performance. So the most recent video you put out there, and it's going to tell you how well that video has done compared to the rest of your videos. You can see this particular video has been out for almost 3 days and it's the number 1 out of the last 10. And when you hover over this, you can see how your videos rank for when they were published recently. You're also gonna get a glimpse of your views, your impression click-through rates, video analytics, and all of that. You can go straight from here. Then the other thing you're gonna look at in your dashboard when you're checking things is over here. This is basically a snapshot of your channel as a whole, and it's broken down by the last 28 days. So you can see in the last 28 days, I've got over 2,000 subscribers. I've had over 117,000 views, and that's up 28%. So you can see that green arrow showing up as an increase, and when you hover over it, it shows you what the last 28 days were. So the previous 28 days, I had about 91,000 views. And the same thing with your revenue and watch time. And again, this is going to show you your top videos in the last 48 hours. What's different between this and this particular one? This is measuring how your videos stacked up to each other based on the time they were live. And this is real time, like what's happening on your channel right now. So this particular video, what to say in your first YouTube video, had over 1,600 views in the last 48 hours. This one had over 1,000 views in the last 48 hours. So this is telling you what videos are doing well on your channel right now and giving you an idea of what content maybe you should be double downing on, because if these are getting a lot of traffic, which I'm gonna show you how to look at that even more here in a little bit, this is what your audience is wanting from you and you should definitely try to create more content around this topic. And I mean, there are updates to other things on YouTube right here, like news, what's new in the studio and stuff, but that's your dashboard. Now let's really dig into those numbers. So you're gonna go over here to your analytics on your left-hand panel, and this is gonna give your channel overview for a whole for the last 28 days. So this is looking at all of your videos, everything on your channel for the last 28 days. And YouTube will usually give you some information right at the top here so you can get a quick glimpse of what is happening. You're seeing my views are up, that's more than normal. And again, this is in the last 28 days, so April 11th through March 8th, so when I'm shooting this. And you can always change this, so you can look at just May, just April, just March, whatever time frame you wanna look at. I suggest doing it monthly, so you will have the data for the entire month, usually around the 3rd of the month. You wanna make sure all that data, all the subscribers, all the views and stuff are accumulated into what you're seeing. So I generally say to do a monthly report on your channel once a month by the 3rd or 4th of the month. So what this is actually showing us is real-time data. So real-time subscribers, real-time views in the last 48 hours, over 7,000 views in the last 48 hours. And again, this is also showing us those top videos that we saw on the dashboard. What this is showing us, so this is the overview tab, and we're gonna go through each of these tabs individually. The overview tab is showing you how many views, watch time, subscribers, and your estimated revenue for the last 28 days. And it's going to give you a little green up arrow if it's increased from the last 28 days. You can also hover over this to see exactly what your typical range is. So in the last 28 days, I've had over 117,000 views. My typical is 45,000 to 56,000. Same with watch time, same with subscribers. You can see generally I get around 600 to 820 subscribers in 28 days. I got 2,000 in the last 28 days. And then this is going to give you more than the top three. So you see, these are your top three here. And this is going to give you the top 10 in the last 28 days. Also, what's really important to look here is look at your average view duration. So if one of these videos looks really high, I know this is a short video, so that's why this one is high. But let's say this video had over 50% average view duration. That meant people were really watching that video. I'd want to go in here, look at this video, see if there's more content I can create from this particular topic since people liked it. So that's what you're getting here at the overview. To see anything on a graph here, you might need to take it out for a longer time frame. So if we do the last, let's do in 2020, you can see how my channel took a huge spike here about the time COVID happened and people started to be sheltered in place. That's where you can start to see those big changes when you get a little bit wider of a picture. Sometimes in 28 days, it can be hard to see because your growth seems to be so slow, but when you pull it back, you can really see that increase in growth. Let's take this back to 28 days. And again, this is your entire channel as a whole. What we're gonna look at is reach. So we're looking at how many impressions this means. And if you hover over these, YouTube gives you more detail. This is how many times your video thumbnails were shown to viewers. Includes only impressions on YouTube. So this doesn't include like Google search. This doesn't include your blog, just on YouTube. This is your impression click-through rate on average for your entire channel. So again, your click-through rate, if you hover, it's gonna tell you views per impressions shown. This measures how often viewers watch the video after seeing an impression, all right? Same with views are up. So unique views, again, if you ever wonder, you can come up here. This is the estimated number of people that watch your content within a selected date range. So these are the people where these are the views. Some people may be watching the same video a couple times. They may be coming back to your channel. But again, the reason why I tell you to wait till about the third or the fourth of the month, you can see right here, the previous 2 days are processing here. So that's why I just say give it some time. On down here, that's really important to look here in the reach section is your traffic sources. So this is gonna tell you in the last 28 days where your traffic is coming from to your YouTube channel. You see the bulk of my traffic the last 28 days has been 50% of YouTube search. And then external, and I'm gonna show you how to see what exactly external means here in a minute. Suggested, other YouTube features, browse features, and so forth. Ideally, if you really wanna see your YouTube channel take off, you would want browse features and suggested videos to really be one of your top 3 to 4 traffic sources. Because what this means is that YouTube is actually promoting your videos for you by putting them in suggested and browse. So that means you've kind of validated to YouTube you have great content and they're gonna put it out to more people. Now, impressions and how they led to watch time is a little more important in individual videos, but for your entire channel, this is gonna tell you in 28 days, you had over 1.6 million impressions. Of that, 29% is YouTube recommending it. So that's why the browse and the search are so important, because you really wanna get this number as high as possible. So if we go back to my March date specifically and look at this number, you'll see that YouTube was recommending my content 25%. So I've actually increased the amount of traffic I'm getting from YouTube recommending my videos. So again, just something to look at, see, okay, is YouTube recommending my videos? If they aren't, why not? What can I do to change that? And that's gonna be the three analytics you should be looking at every single month, which I'm gonna tell you here at the end. So again, this funnel just goes from impressions to how many people clicked on your videos, is how many views you got, average view duration of all of your videos across all your channel, led to watch time from impression hours. And again, if any of this stuff doesn't make sense, you can just hover over this and YouTube gives you a definition. Now moving on down here, this is exactly where that external traffic source is coming from. So you can see a bulk of my external traffic source is coming from Google. 37% of the 18% from external traffic is coming from Google. Right there, 10% of the external traffic is coming from Pinterest. And again, that is why I really focus on my Pinterest strategy, because it's usually my top 1 or 2 traffic source. If you have playlists, you're gonna see that over here. This is the videos that are actually suggesting your videos. If your videos aren't getting people to watch more of your videos, why would YouTube ever put your videos in somebody else's suggested videos, right? If your own people or the person that clicked on your video initially isn't gonna watch another one from you, what's to say they're gonna watch one from you on somebody else's channel? So you really wanna make sure some of your videos are in here and you wanna see what other videos are recommending you. If we look at this one, number one, we can go to this particular video. If you go to see more and you come in here, you can hover over this and you'll see that Sunny Leonard Doozy's video. I am actually getting traffic from this video. People watch her video and see me in suggested and then they watch my video. The bulk of these are my own. So you can see all of these other than this one. I don't know that channel. This is TubeBuddy, I believe. This is, I don't know that channel. but you can start to see the bulk of these videos are mine, and that's a good thing. So you can see this video from Jillian is actually getting me traffic as well. So I'm showing up in her suggested videos on that side panel when people watch this. So what I could do to really maximize that traffic is go to her channel and go to Sunny's channel and see what videos people are watching a lot of on their channels, and can I put my own spin on it? Can I give my own way of teaching those topics so I could continue to show up on their suggested videos? Okay, if we close out of that, one other thing to look at here is your traffic source from YouTube search, the actual words that are driving you traffic to your channel in the last 28 days. So this has been a number one for me, first YouTube video, how to share YouTube videos on Instagram. So of the 50% coming from YouTube search, over 5% of them are finding my channel by typing in the word first YouTube video. 2% of them are finding me by typing in the word how to share YouTube videos on Instagram, okay? So this is how you can really break down what kind of content is working for you, what kind of content your audience is coming to you for. So let's move on here to engagement. This is going to give you your watch time hours, your average view duration, some of your top videos by watch time. So which videos are being watched longer. Now, this is another important one here. Top videos by end screen. These are videos that are getting people to watch more of your content. So these are the videos that are getting the highest click-through rates on your end screen. What to say in your first YouTube video? I should go to that video and see specifically what I said at the end and what video I'm pitching at the end. You can hover over this and it's going to tell you your channel's most effective end screen videos. This shows the videos with the end screens that viewer click the most. These five videos are causing people to watch more content on my channel. They're clicking my end screen. So that's why it's really important to focus on those end screens, because you can see these really reflect these videos over here that are my top videos because they have the highest end screen click-through rate. Now let's move over here to audience. There's one thing that I want to show you. This will show you how many subscribers you grew in the last 28 days. But what's brand new on YouTube here is they're showing you when your viewers are on YouTube. So the darker areas are actually when, if you hover over it, very many of your viewers are on YouTube. So they're most active around noon to one. I want to get that video out just a little bit earlier so it's out there in the world. So I would probably want to, which I already do, want to post around 11, maybe even 10 a.m. So I'm posting on a Wednesday. If I hit Wednesday around 10 a.m., many of your viewers on YouTube, then very. So that gives me a good idea of when to post on YouTube. Also, what to look at specifically is watch time from subscribers. So this is my biggest problem right now. So many of you are watching me, but you aren't actually subscribed to my channel. So I need to figure out how to make a better connection with you to make you want to subscribe. So just a little hint, if you aren't subscribed yet, make sure you hit that red subscribe button down below so you can be notified and I will show up in your homepage if you're subscribed and watching to me. So if you actually see 90% of people watching your videos are subscribed, that's another problem. That means you're not getting in front of new people. So I mean, in a perfect world, you maybe would want, you know, 50-50 here so that new people are finding you, but your subscribers are actually watching your videos and liking them. That's something really important to look at. Now let's go into individual videos so you can figure out how to make your content better and the three analytics you should always be looking at in your individual videos. Now to go to your individual video analytics, you're gonna go to your video tab and then you're gonna click on this little analytics button. Specifically, again, if you're low on no time at all, what you need to be looking at for every single video you publish is one, click-through rate, two, audience retention, and three, end screen click-through rate. So I'm gonna show you that in a second, but the other thing you wanna look at is how well this video did compared to your channel average. So this chart right here on the overview is going to show you this gray area, and you see that's what videos typically perform for me. This video is this blue line, and it's doing really well. So this is a signal to me, if I have a video going off the chart, so to speak, I should create more content around this because people are responding to it, people are liking it, and it's really taking off for me. That's why that blue line is above the gray area. So if you ever have a video that you post and you're checking it and it's that blue line is above the gray, double down on that content again. That is good content. That is where you really should be focusing some of your newer videos on. This is the overview tab. What you want to look at here specifically is your audience retention. This is where you can go in here and watch your video minute by minute, second by second, and see exactly where people drop off and maybe where they're watching more. So you see this bump? This is because people people are rewinding and watching something here. So this could be good content for me to know to focus on. I see that in the first 38 seconds, there's quite a dip in audience retention. So I need to figure out what's gonna hook you more. What are you interested in? What do you wanna hear at the beginning to actually keep watching my videos? And that's something you definitely wanna be looking at in every single one of your videos, because if you aren't looking at this audience retention graph, you're never going to know if you're making better content, and YouTube's not gonna recommend your content if it's not good and people aren't watching it. So this is really important. Probably, if you work on anything, this would be the graph you should look at. Now, if we go back over here to reach, you're gonna see your click-through rate. And if you click on that click-through rate, you're gonna see it by day. In the first day, it had a 3.9% click-through rate. In the second day, it had a 5.8% click-through rate. So you're gonna be able to see the average right here. You're also gonna see how are you getting traffic from this video. Majority is browse feature, which is a good thing. It means YouTube is promoting it on the browse page and people are clicking on it yesterday over 5% of the time. And then it breaks it on down. Now here's this inverted triangle again. What you wanna look at for every single video is, can we get this number higher? Which videos are getting the highest percentage from YouTube recommending your content? Because YouTube is recommending it, it has a higher click-through rate, it has a higher audience retention, and end screen click-through rate. That's your good content, that's your bread and butter, that's where you should focus. Now if we go on down here to traffic source, again, you're gonna see external. So I send it to my newsletter, there's my Gmail. You're gonna see the specific words people are finding this. So how to promote your YouTube channel. So this one was three ways to promote your YouTube video. Maybe I do a video on how to promote your channel and talk specifically about a channel as a whole, since this video did so well. And again, the videos that are suggesting your videos. The last thing that you need to look at for every single video is here in engagement. And you really, really want to do what you can to increase this end screen element click-through rate. All right, you see my channel average as a whole is 3.8. This video was a 5.5%, meaning people that got to the last 20 seconds to see the end screen, 5.5% click-through to another video. Remember earlier on, we looked at those videos with the highest end screen click-through rate. They were my top performers. So you really want to focus on how you can get this end screen click-through rate up. So in the audience tab, you can see what I look at is how much of my watch time is coming from subscribers. So for this video, over 70% of the watch time is coming from subscribers versus non-subscribers. Where my channel as a whole, 90% of the watch time is coming from non-subscribers. So I know my audience is really liking this content since the view time is coming from this. And I do believe this has only been out for a few days. This will increase it as it starts to get shown more and more as YouTube starts to recommend it more. One thing I wanted to show you was, okay, we're back at the dashboard again. And we saw how that top video, what to say in your first video, had the highest end screen click-through rate. So what you can do is come in here and actually go to the engagement tab and see what that percentage was. So it has a 6.7% end screen click-through rate, right? Almost a percentage more than my most recent video. So I kind of know, okay, this is a goal for me to want to get my videos higher. Since this is the highest end screen click-through rate that I have, I want to get this to a 10. We see channels who can hit like a 10% more end screen click-through rate really take off. So let's not let YouTube decide whether or not your YouTube videos should thrive or not. Do your own promotion of your videos. I have the video right now on your screen, the 7 ways to promote your YouTube videos that I showed here in this tutorial. So click on that video and see all the ways I tell you to take your YouTube channel into your own hands and start getting it to grow without relying on YouTube. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel, because I'm gonna be breaking down all of these tips and tutorials for you every single week.